Hi, I'm Minor Childers. I'm one of the co-founders of .eco. One of our founding principles states that we will defer to the experts on how best to use the funds generated from .eco. In that case, we're working with the Sierra Club, Surfrider Foundation, as well as the Alliance for Climate Protection, and individuals like Al Gore. Continuing our work with people who are actually in the environmental community, people who know the science, people who know how to make a difference, I'm very excited to introduce my good friend, my environmental mentor, the new Chief Environmental Officer for .eco, Jim DeFore.
Thanks, Minor. I really appreciate it, and this is a wonderful opportunity. I'm so excited to be put on board.
Tell us a bit about yourself.
Well, Minor, I've been working at the University of California, San Diego, Scripps Institution of Oceanography for 30 years as an oceanographic engineer. And my whole job was to create new and unique instrumentation for scientific discovery and environmental issues.
How did you come to .eco?
We've been friends for over 5 years, and our group of friends are very committed to environmental change. I think that the reason why we become such strong friends is because we all have diverse backgrounds, and we all have one focused objective, and that is to help create solutions to this problem.
Can you tell us what are the issues for a researcher? Are they funding? Is it outreach? Is it attracting new young scientists? What are your primary concerns?
It's an interesting question, and I believe you've hit on all the high topics. First of all, every one of those topics that you just discussed are critical and absolutely important and necessary to trying to solve this problem. We know that we have issues that regard funding and the dwindling of resources and funding that will help promote scientific research as an issue. Outreach component, behavioral modification, that is, how are we going to make sure that people understand that their behavior will have to change in order to make change? But the outreach component in education, to me, is by far one of the most critical aspects. We've been working on this for years at the K-12 level and at the university level, and we can see that with dwindling educational resources, resources like .eco are going to have to be able to pick up the pace to help keep this moving forward.
As .eco's new Chief Environmental Officer, what are you bringing to .eco?
Well, this is the part that I love most, I must say. For the better part of 2 years now, since we first started talking about a program that would include either top-level domain or environmental change, I've been dreaming about the different programs that I would like to bring on board. We're going to give them more information, but just not the same kind of content that's been driven down everybody's throats for the last 10 years of the environmental movement. It's going to be very clear, concise, truthful information that comes from resources that can take very complicated, sometimes very interesting, but yet very difficult to digest information and make it available to the community in a format that people can understand, so that someday, when this issue becomes the topic of almost every discussion, people will be able to be experts in the field, literally, because the information that they got was from the homepage that they review every morning, the .eco homepage.
One of our competitors, that is one of the groups who is submitting a competing application for .eco, proposes to use the space for eco-labeling. Do you think that that's a good use for the space?
It takes our focus away from what's important. It takes our attention and draws it towards the sort of advertising branding which has no place in the environmental movement. There's so many people out there and organizations out there that just reek of phoniness. I mean, I don't know how else to put it. And I believe that when you lay things down on the table and you go back to research, back to scientists, back to the engineers that, you know, have been spending years and years for low pay, working in a laboratory, and their only objective is to get out there and get that science, they look at this and they can just see right through it. I mean, it's just as clear as day. You can see right through it.
So you think that this is the best usage, that .eco LLC's approach is the best usage
of
the .eco top-level domain space?
Absolutely. In fact, I can't even begin to tell you the sort of positive input that I've had in the scientific community. Everybody that I've talked to looks at this and gets it immediately, understands the model that's been presented, understands the importance of science and research in this. There has never been a model like this before. This is a unique situation that we've created, and I'm really proud to be part of that.
Jim, thank you very much.